Oh, didn't see you there. Is it Monday already again? Has it been a week? No watch on my wrist. But I guess it is. So we're back again for another Melody's Music Highlights for decent music suggestions. I know you guys are, you know, following this for that reason. But if you're not, just click that follow button on my page and you might regret it, but maybe today you won't, because I might give decent music suggestions. One day we'll be up to par with the suggestions, but whoever wants to give those sentiments, my DMs are open. But anyways, we are back to talk about a few songs, and of course the songs that I talk about are on my Melody's Music Highlights August 2019 playlist. Link in bio. We got a Spotify playlist, we got an Apple Music playlist, we got a YouTube playlist, and of course another teaser. As always, every week I give a teaser, but there's gonna be two in this story. One teaser is I have some songs on my playlist that I don't talk about here, so that's a tease for my playlist. And of course I have a teaser for one of the tracks that I'll be discussing, but again, we will keep that a mystery until we get to that song. But of course, the four songs that we're talking about today: number one, Katy Perry's new song Small Talk; number two, Sir's new track with Kendrick Lamar, Hair Down; number three, we're talking about Megan Thee Stallion, Ty Dolla $ign, and Nicki Minaj's Hot Girl Summer song; and of course, number four is a mystery. We love a teaser, as always, on Melody's Music Highlights, so let's go talk about it. Okay, let's talk about Katy Perry's new song, Small Talk. It dropped on Friday, and the first note that I want to make is I'm really glad this was not her debut comeback single, and I'm glad she went with Never Really Over, because this song, Small Talk, ain't it. Okay, but let me backtrack on that. Both of these singles are superior to Witness. I mean, Witness, if Witness was in my hand, boop, in the trash, and we can all agree with that, ladies and gentlemen, because I mean, she even knows that it was bad. Like, I don't know who at her label was like, this is it. Like, it's not. Like, whatever she experimented with, I'm glad hopefully it's out of her system and we're not gonna go back to that, because the only good thing about Witness, and I'm treading the statement lightly, is the singles. And by singles, I mean the first one, Chained to the Rhythm, because like Bon Appetit and Swish Swish, they're not like critically acclaimed singles. They were stupid funny songs that were catchy and that I have it on repeat, correct, but that's not the point here. Small Talk, it's written with Charlie Puth. Of course, Katy Perry is credited. Who knows what she wrote? And then two other people. All I want to know is, and I'm going to quote a lyric from the song, direct lyric. And it goes, blah, 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 blah. I wish I was joking. That is the verse before the bridge. I just want to know, like, who wrote that? Like, what share they're getting from this song? You know, like, what? How much are they getting? Because if this is like cashing in on this money-making lyric, bro, sign me up. Like, publishing groups, call me. Performing rights organizations, call me. Like, I can make songs with those lyrics, like stacks of them. Like, don't you worry, like, I'll be a hit maker in no time. But seriously, you guys, I was like left in shock when I was listening to that. I'm like, no way someone in that writing session was like, yes, that is it, blah 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 blah, that's what the kids want. No, we don't, but it's a good enough song, so let's listen. We were lovers and now there's nothing left but small talk. How to be into your skin, there's no you have to be big. Ain't it funny, cause now there's nothing left but small talk, blah 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 blah. So the second track I'm really excited to talk about, because it is Sir's new single called Hair Down, featuring none other than, if you know me even slightly, my fave, one of the greatest of all time, Kendrick Lamar. Don't fight me on if he's one of the greatest of all time, because we don't dispute facts here, ladies and gentlemen. Correct, live studio audience? Correct. But for my visual learners out there, this is Kendrick Lamar. Take it in. I feel like Mr. Rogers when I'm like, for my visual learners out there, but won't you be my neighbor? Okay, I'm sorry. I'm not gonna disrespect the king of education like that. May he rest in peace, Mr. Rogers, an icon for many generations, period. But jokes aside, Sir, he is an R&B singer-songwriter, producer, has worked with legends, has released incredible pieces of art, if you would like to say that. He's worked with Anderson .Paak, he's worked with Schoolboy Q, he's worked with Edda Bond. Now I got Kendrick Lamar, because Kendrick Lamar is basically his boss, fellow Top Dog Entertainment. He signed a few years ago, but I've been listening to him for a few years now, especially his EP that came out just about 3 years ago. I highly suggest everyone listen to that. But truly, his lyrics speak volume. Even if it's so simplistic, to one person it could be just simple, but to another person it could really affect them in a way that they wouldn't think a song would. And that's what he does. And I feel like the more you listen to the song and the more you kind of break it down, you can see the storytelling that Sir creates in not only this song but his other songs. So let's take a listen. No dust, I got the anesthesia. When you chose up, this ain't a fantasy. We about to go up, see at the hand of me. Never got no love, but understand to me. Maybe come on us and baby, I'm just trying to let my head down. Baby, I'm just trying. Okay, let's talk about the third track, which is Megan Thee Stallion's new song with Nicki Minaj and Ty Dolla $ign called Hot Girl Summer. Now, with anyone with a pulse and a social media account, they have probably seen the caption, the tag, the hashtag with the term Hot Girl Summer. Now listen, we give credit when credit is due here on Melody's Music Highlights. So out of those three artists, I don't know whose idea it was or someone on their team, the fact that they made a song off of a term that's being used constantly and it's just popping off and they're like, let's monetize it off of this somehow and make a song about it, it's like brilliant. And the fact that the song is actually a good hot rap single for the summer just balances it even better at this point. So great for them. And the fact that we have three types of artists on the song. We got Megan Thee Stallion, who's like a young rapper who's been in the game for a minute and is finally getting like the momentous traction and the momentous engagement. Then we got Nicki Minaj, who in her own right once solidified herself as like an iconic female rapper for this generation, who needs every help that she can get at this point. And then we got Ty Dolla $ign, a rapper with very nice eyes and is also just like a featured rapper at this point. So it's like, cool, like tie that ribbon to yourself. There you go. That's what you get. But honestly, going back to the Nicki Minaj point, she really does need this song because at this point, she's just being a featured artist on remixes or just new song with on the rise artists or artists who were on the rise and just like broke the ceiling at this point. Because we all know after, hopefully, like we know that like after her latest album release last year, Queen, it did well enough, but it's like her European tour like was hanging on a limb, and then she wanted to do two different US tours that both fell flat. It's like, Nicki, what are you doing at this point? It's like, how much is Apple Music paying you for Queen Radio? Because we know touring is where the money's at. So it's like, she's like, yeah, let me feature on like Chance the Rapper's album and this relevant rapper's artists, they're relevant, and let me feature on this. Because listen, at the end of the day, all these artists have an expiration date and Nicki just keeps on renewing her, so good for her. And this song is actually good for her career, so let's listen. Hot girl summer, so you know she got it lit. Know she got it lit. Hot girl summer, so you know she got it lit, yeah. No, she got it lit. Hot girl summer, so you know she got it lit, yeah. Who a how to be? Who got a lot of D? Who arrived to the final track? The teaser that has kept everyone on the edge of their seats, because I could feel it every week through the screen. That was songwriting gold material. Again, publishing groups, PROs, call me, because that is better than blah, 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 blah in that Katy Perry song. Still not over that. Never really over. Puns after puns after puns here on Melody's Music Highlights. I know, no one asks for them. But let's get on to it. The final track that I want to talk about is from this pop trio band Public with their song that they just re-released this summer called Make You Mine. And they just got signed to Island Records. But the best way I could describe this off the top of my head, and I mean this as a compliment, is if you took Walk the Moon, the band, and American Authors, morphed them, and it would be this band, this song. Again, I mean that in a compliment. Not that that would be offensive, but you never know how people might perceive that. But I mean that in a positive way. But fun fact for everyone, this song was actually released 4 years ago. And that is a great lesson of the music industry for everyone, because you could hear a song and you could be like, this is a hit. Like, this needs streams. This needs to be on radio. But for some reason, like, it doesn't have the spark. or doesn't have the traction that it needs at the moment, at that time that it came out, but you never know, it may blow up in a few months, in a few years. That's happened to several songs, several artists that we know of them now. So you never know, if you're listening to a song right now and be like, this is a hit, but no one's believing you, you never know, and you could be one of those people to be like, I knew about this song before all of you did, before it went on radio. So this is an example of a song that's like that, that now and even before, it hasn't aged and it's perfect right now for pop. We should stream it, we should listen to it, and it's called Make Your Mind by Public. Put your hand in mine. You know that I want to be with you.